This video will demonstrate the basic steps that you need to follow to successfully search an academic database. Academic databases contain articles from journals, magazines, and newspaper, and in addition, some databases contain streaming music or streaming video. If your research requires an academic, scholarly, or peer-reviewed source, academic databases are the way to go. Temple College Libraries subscribes to a wide variety of academic databases, from general to subject-specific. Please note that if you are accessing databases from off-campus, you will be required to log in with your Temple College username and password. If you encounter any difficulty accessing databases, please take a screenshot and contact the library for assistance. Let's begin. To access TCL academic databases, navigate to the library's homepage by clicking this link at the top of Temple College's homepage. From the TCL homepage, the academic databases are located under the Databases and Articles tab at left. From the Databases and Articles page, you can access TCL databases in two ways. The A to Z databases list is located here. This takes you to an alphabetic listing of all of our databases. Click on the title of the database to access it. In addition, you can use the subject tabs. Click on the tab to see the databases under that subject. Click on the title of the database to access it. In this demonstration, we will consider Academic Search Complete. Academic Search Complete is a great all-around general academic database that contains a wide variety of formats, including newspapers, journals, magazines, and even streaming video. Academic Search Complete is a great place to start your research. Please note that for in-depth research in specific subject areas like nursing or literature, using subject-specific databases is your best bet. Please watch our other screencasts for directions on how to search subject-specific databases. Academic Search Complete is an EBSCO database. The user interface for EBSCO databases generally looks exactly like this. You can see the name of the specific EBSCO database here above the advanced search window. Most academic databases default to an advanced search window. This offers a combination of search fields and Boolean operators like what you see here. Academic databases cannot be searched in the same way we search Google. Rather, they require a combination of keywords and Boolean operators to search. Let's talk about keywords first. Keywords are words that describe your topic. Effective searching comes down to a good combination of keywords. To generate a pool of keywords to choose from, it's helpful to consider the broader, narrower, and related ideas of your topic. For example, if social media was my topic, broader related topics might be something like mass communication or user-generated content. Narrower related concepts could be Facebook or blogs. And related topics could be something like data mining or photo sharing. To search an academic database, keywords are combined using what are called Boolean operators. Boolean operators are the words and, or, and not. For example, To narrow a search and make it more specific, you combine two keywords with the Boolean operator AND. This instructs the database, for example, to find all articles that include both keywords, social media, and data mining. If I want the search to capture the topic more broadly, I can use the Boolean operator OR and add a related keyword. For example, I could add social networks to social media using OR. The Boolean operator NOT is used to exclude keywords that are irrelevant to my search. For example, Facebook, not Twitter, is what I would enter if I only want to see articles on social media and Facebook, not social media and Twitter. To search, all keywords are combined using the Boolean operators in the advanced search fields. Note, the Boolean operators are located in the pull-down menu at left. Also note, whenever you combine two or more words together, put them in quotations. This instructs the database to search them together as a phrase. Before initiating a search in an EBSCO database, be sure to toggle the full text box to ensure that all your results include full text. This is a search results page, but before turning to the results themselves, please note the options for sorting and limiting at left. For example, you can limit your results to scholarly, peer-reviewed journals. You can limit by date. And you can limit by source type, such as academic journals, journals, or newspapers. Now let's consider the results. Because we clicked the full text button before we initiated the search, all the results have full text attached. Note that each entry lets you know what type of source it is right here. This, for example, is an article in an academic journal. Clicking on the title opens the record for this article. The record contains helpful information and tools, including publication information and subject terms. Please note that subject terms are hyperlinks, and you can click on these links to view other resources under that same subject in this database. Also note the Google Drive, email, save, cite, and permanent link options at right. The Google Drive option allows you to add this entry to your Google Drive. The email option allows you to email this article to yourself. The cite option generates an automatic citation for this article. Make sure that you choose the correct citation style. And note that there are no guarantees that an automatic citation is correct. You should always proof your citations. The permalink option generates a permanent link for this resource that you can copy and paste. Click on the PDF full text icon at left to access this article. Please note that the PlumX metrics icon is not a full text link, but rather it is a link to the statistics for this article. Once you click on the full text link, you have access to the article and you're ready to go. Repeat these steps with different combinations of keywords and using a variety of databases until you have located the research that you need. If you don't find many results with your initial keywords, search again using alternative keywords from your pool. And remember, narrower, broader, and related words. And if you're having any trouble, don't hesitate to reach out to library staff for assistance. This concludes our review of the basic steps necessary to successfully search an academic database. Feel free to reach out to library staff with any questions. Our contact information is located here, or try our new live chat. And don't forget to check out our additional screencasts.